Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you very much, IATA, for inviting me to address such a high-quality audience and meeting. Let me make sure that this thing works. Okay, before that. Coming from a small airline, I will talk in a very pragmatic way about technology and innovation, taking experience from the day-to-day business that we have been running for the past 20 years. I have to start saying a few things about Aegean, not for marketing purposes, I leave that to our passengers, but because they relate directly to the topic, of the presentation. In Aegean, we have managed not only to survive the Greek crisis, but we got out of the crisis having grown Aegean and having made it more solid and stronger financially. We have more than doubled our activity and our revenue. We have more than quadrupled our international network, which now contributes 80% of our revenues. We have almost tripled our EBITDA and pre-tax profits in the past 6 years, while contributing and delivering healthy dividends to our shareholders and maintaining a very strong cash position relative to our 1 billion revenue base. So how have we managed that? We have done that by being religiously focused on two things. The first one is delivering consistent quality service to our customers. The second is running an efficient and productive organization. In an intra-European traffic, which is extremely competitive, we compete against more than 70 airlines. Every single full-service carrier in Europe and every single low-cost carrier in Europe is a competitor of ours in any of the routes that we fly. In such a competitive environment, we need to be able to offer a very distinct value for money proposition to our customer if we are going to win our customer. So quality service, consistent service quality allows us to differentiate from our competitors, and an efficient and productive organization allows us to compete on price against pretty much everybody, full service and low-cost carriers. And it seems like the passengers do recognize and do reward us for those efforts. We have been voted by the passengers in the Skytrax competition, in the Condé Nast Travelers Readers' Choice Awards. We have been getting the top ranking, the best net promoter score in the Star Alliance Customer Satisfaction Survey for service consistency. So, as I said, it seems like the passengers do recognize our efforts. What are the key levers, the key management levers that we use in order to pursue our objectives? And those are also very simple key management levers. We invest a lot in our human capital. We invest a lot in developing the skills and the capabilities of our people, because we believe that this is really the asset that makes the difference, and this is the asset that cannot be imitated and copied easily. It takes time to develop a good group of people, and it's very, very difficult to imitate. Second, we do invest in technology, and now we come to the substance of the talk. We do invest in technology not because it creates a competitive advantage, but because it helps our people to deliver good quality service to our customers. A technology does not create competitive advantage because it's readily available. The same technology is available for all airlines by the technology providers. Therefore, we can easily buy technology. And if we do something innovative in technology, it can easily be imitated. Whatever we do today as Aegean or as Lufthansa, 3, 4, 5 months later, latest 1 year later, it can be copied by everybody. So technology itself is not delivering competitive advantage. People and culture does. So technology. There's a lot of hype about technology. We live in a times that it sounds like it's the revolutionary, technologically revolutionary times. Buzzwords about learning, machine learning, deep learning, shallow learning, neural networks, artificial intelligence, a lot of futurology taking place. I mean, I heard the other day a guy claiming that, you know, artificial intelligence will surpass human intelligence by 2045. He forgot to mention the date and the time only. But other than that, he was very precise about his prediction. So there is a lot of hype, but let's take a look about how this hype translates to real results, starting from our own industry. How long, most of you are airliners, how long have you been hearing the EMD initiative to deliver the EMD functionality. I have been in this industry for 20 years, and at least for the past 15 years, I've been listening about the EMD. The EMD is still not there in its full functionality. Still not there, 15 years later. Take another case. We are living in the age of instant and cheap communication. But for airlines, this is a completely different communication world. If a call center wants to send a message to the airport office, it needs to go through the very cryptic and mystical Type B messaging mechanism. Why? What is so mystical about airline communication when the rest of the world uses internet and standard communication modes? There is nothing mystical about it. There are other reasons behind it, but it's not mystical. So we talk a lot about the technology hype, but reality does land us in a completely different landscape. There are other things about technology which have been, there's been a lot of talk, you know, since the early 90s. I was back then an engineer, and I was part of a team that drove a driverless Mercedes from Stuttgart to Berlin. We still talk about driverless cars 30 years later, and we are going to be still talking about driverless cars for many other years, because the step from theory to real implementation is a long one, and it's a difficult one. It takes a lot of details. Those futurology cycles in technology, they repeat themselves in about every 20, 25 years. If somebody read The Economist of the early 90s, he would read articles about the destruction of the world through the robots and all that stuff. Nothing from those things happened. Things do not happen overnight. The translation of good theoretical technological achievements to real implementations that deliver value to any industry takes much longer than people anticipate. So technology in itself, and now we go to the really the heart topic of the issue. Technology itself in itself is not innovation. It becomes only then innovation if it translates to something which delivers better service to our customer or improves our internal processes as an airline. Technology in itself also does not create competitive advantage. And I mentioned earlier why. We are not technology developers and providers. We buy technology from third-party guys. So every airline has access to the same technology that everybody else has. The difference is not the technology itself. It's how you use the technology to translate it to useful, good customer experience for our passengers or to improve our internal processes. And this is, I quote Bill Gates about the rules of new technology introduced in any industry. And he says, the first rule of any technology used in any business is that automation applied to an efficient operation will magnify efficiency. The same automation, if applied to an inefficient operation, will just magnify inefficiency. In other words, technology itself does not make the difference. It's how the organization uses technology to deliver useful results. In our case, in the airline case, to deliver good service to our customers and improve the customer experience and improve then our internal processes that make us more efficient. This is what makes technology a competitive tool, not technology itself. And the third issue about technology innovation is the revolution versus evolution. As I said earlier, we live in technologically revolutionary times. A lot of hype, a lot, but this is not the first time it happens. In Aegean, we have the following pillars that reflect how we introduce technology and innovation in our company. We believe that it's going to be an evolutionary process and not a revolution. And on that front, legacy technology is a huge drag in our business, huge drag, and creates additional obstacles apart from the conservatism that Mr. Zunyak himself mentioned in his talk earlier. Airline industry is a conservative industry by nature, but the legacy technology from many of our technology providers is another big drag in the process. We believe that many coherent small improvements will make the difference and not few big bangs. We do measure the customer acceptance of each innovation we roll out because it's innovation not for us. Supposedly we innovate for the customer. It's not what we believe it is an innovation. The important thing is whether the customer believes that this is an innovation for his journey. And we measure commercial and relevant performance and commercial and financial performance and relevance of any innovation we roll out. So those are the four pillars based on which we roll out and we introduce new technologies and roll out innovations in Aegean. Now, how do we do it? What do we do in practice? In practice, and I mentioned that from the very beginning, we focus a lot on our people. We develop, and we have been developing for the past 20 years, a culture which is extremely focused on the customer, and it's also focused on developing process and technology skills for our people. All the way from the selection process to the development process of every employee, we do pay attention in developing on having customer focus and having process and technology skills. We listen a lot to our people. Again, why? Because our people know best and sense best than anybody else the real needs of the customer along the customer journey. And obviously, we use technology to improve customer journey, to simplify day-to-day job of our people. Why? Because if we simplify their job, they will have more time free to take care of our customer and our passenger. And whatever simplifies the day-to-day job of every employee, at the end of the day, it translates to better efficiency and reduced costs. It's not very tangible, but it's always there. And third, we use technology to empower employees to deal with the unexpected. Take into account the famous discussion that's taken place recently in the airline world about disruption management. How can you take a disruption, which is a bad experience for a customer, and make out of it a good, loyal customer? So I will give you now, I'm already 10 minutes in my talk, so I have another 5 minutes to conclude. I have two specific examples of innovations we rolled out in Aegean. One, in fact, comes from the disruption management area. And we have created in-house with a software house that we employ an automatic an application whereby when we know that the bag of a passenger has not been loaded on his plane, on his flight, we create automatically a PIR which we push to the customer, to the passenger 10 minutes after blocks on at destination. This way, we spare the customer the anxiety of waiting on the belt. We send him the PIR pre-populated with the data that we have from his trip, and we ask him, based on all the IATA norms, to fill the rest of the PIR, and we notify him then for every step in our search and delivery process for his bag. It has a small acceptance. We rolled this thing out last summer, but it's something which is still, it's slowly gaining acceptance by the passenger. It's still very difficult to convince a passenger when his bag has not arrived to not to talk to a physical person. But we will get there. So we improve the reliability of the application, and we see an increasing uptake of the service. The second application is an application which is also developed in-house by one of our pilots, who is a very technology-savvy pilot, who decided, he said, look, you know, we have now all our pilots and our cabin crew, they have laptops, they have tablets in there, because we have paperless cockpit, paperless cabin. He said, why don't we give them an application which allows them to report back from their flights instead of writing papers left and right to immediately send back their flight reports, cockpit and cabin. So this whole application started from this concept to improve communication between ops management and our cabin and cockpit crews. And when we saw the acceptance, then we start giving more information, pushing more information to our crews. So we start giving information about the kind of ground handling services we source in different airports, the parking position of the plane. We allowed our cockpit crew and cabin crew to order their crew meal or the crew meal of their preference, to accommodate their crew transport, even to view their personal roster on their mobile. So this application was developed in-house. There are some screenshots from it. Within a year, and we add for our cabin crew an FAQ, frequently asked questions about the whole palette of Aegean services and products, so that in case our cabin crew gets any request or any question about our services on board, they can immediately go to their tablet, consult the FAQ, and give the passenger real-time the answer to his question. This application was very easily taken up by our crews, cockpit and cabin. It's very, very self-intuitive, so it doesn't require any training because it was developed by a pilot who knows the needs and of the cockpit and the cabin. It's very quick adoption, and now we keep enhancing and making the life of our cabin crew easier. When we realized that the adoption was so high and the user friendliness so good, we started to develop ideas about using the same application as a customer service tool. And now, from an operational tool, we have expanded it to make a customer service tool. We can now differentiate through this application the service that we offer to our passengers that have different frequent flyer tiers. So we can instruct our cabin crew to offer specific services to our gold passengers, to our silver passengers, no matter in which part of the cabin they sit. We can respond real time to customer issues because our cabin crew notifies our customer service upon any issue that happened with any passenger, so our customer service can call the passenger after landing and apologize for spilling coffee and offering to compensate and all that stuff. We push notification to our cabin crew for personalized services to passengers. So in case we had a passenger on board that had a bad experience with us in his last flight, we can instruct, we can ask the chief cabin to go and offer a few thousand miles for free or offer a gift from a duty-free offer. And we even allow now our pilots through the same application to mutually agree roster changes and get approval immediately from our crew planning department. Again, few screenshots from the application. So, closing. In Aegean, we believe that our people is the main driver of innovation, and they do make the difference in innovation. Technology is the enabler, and we keep investing in technology heavily, but it's just a tool to allow our people to deliver better service to the customer. Legacy is a huge drag in this industry, and unless we do something about it, it's going to delay further the pace of adoption of new technologies. And this process is an evolutionary process, not a revolutionary process, as many technologies try to present it. And the last slide that I would like to show, which epitomizes our strategy, is a strategy focused on the passenger, and it's a strategy focused on our people. We do believe this is still and will remain in the foreseeable future people's business. Therefore, small things make a big difference in the eyes of the customer. A nice smile, a friendly behavior towards the customer. In a business, the intra-European business where we compete, which is a very commoditized business, loaded and flooded with LCC. This is the way we understand and we roll out innovation in Aegean. Thank you very much for your attention.